Hello, my friend. Welcome to your sleep story. My name is Stephen Dalton, and it's my great privilege to be the voice that you listen to as you go to sleep tonight. In tonight's story, we will visit the Arctic and meet an Inuit family who live in an igloo, and tonight is a special night for them. For tonight, the northern lights will show themselves. If you find the video helpful, please do hit the like button. Also, do leave a comment or even a suggestion for future stories. This story was suggested by one of you, so thank you. Finally, if you want the video to end at a particular point, don't forget that YouTube provides a timer, which you can find in the settings. And don't forget to disable autoplay, so your sleep won't be disturbed by ads from upcoming videos. Now, before the story, let's do the relaxation session, which will take a few minutes. I'm going to count down from 10 to 1. And as I do, allow yourself to let go more and more. 10. Feeling the support beneath you now. Whether it be your bed, or the floor, or the earth, our home, supporting you. Feel that solidity, that constantness. Nine. Allowing yourself to realize that the day is done now. Whatever has been, has been. Whatever will be, will be. Eight. Allowing my voice to be a voice of safety for you now. You are safe. Maybe feel a little gratitude now for what is offered to you in this moment. The opportunity of sleep. The opportunity of listening to a cozy bedtime story. Six. Remember, we all deserve rest. You deserve rest. Enjoy this moment for its utter simplicity. Five. If you're holding anywhere, let go now. whether it be in your legs, your belly, your face. Your body has worked hard for you today. Let it rest. Four. There is peace that lives within you. It's always there. Allow yourself to see it now. To access it. Allow yourself to feel comforted by that fact. Three. Begin to imagine now a beautiful snowy landscape and a cozy little igloo lit from within. Two. Any residual tension melts away now. You are safe. You can let go. One. Allow your imagination to be fully open now as I take you to a remote, snowy landscape. It's time for your sleep story. In this place, where the sky kisses the earth, there lies a quaint little igloo that a loving family calls home. The exterior, although simple, emanates a warm glow that defies the cold harshness of the Arctic. Inside, plush fur rugs and intricately woven tapestries cover the icy walls, turning what could be a cold dwelling into a cozy sanctuary. The air is filled with the soothing aroma of herbal tea, brewing over a carefully managed fire. Its flickering light casting dancing shadows that tell stories of their own. The family, consisting of a mother, a father, and their two children, are a close-knit bunch, deeply connected to this magical world they live in. They have a unique way of weaving joy into the mundane, making every activity a heartfelt experience. Tonight is special, though. After sharing a hearty meal, they all bundle up in layers of handmade woolen garments and colorful scarves and prepare for the spectacle that the sky is about to unveil. The father, a burly but gentle man, with wisdom and kindness in his eyes, takes a moment to adjust the oil lamp that hangs from the ceiling. It's a family heirloom, an artifact passed down through generations. Its light is more than just illumination. It's a symbol of the family's enduring spirit. Tonight, he says, the sky will tell us stories written in colors. It's the night of the northern lights. The mother, an embodiment of grace and strength, takes her youngest, Anna, into her lap, wrapping her in a soft blanket. The northern lights are the Earth's special light show, she explains, her voice soft and calming. They're a dance of colors and dreams, a celestial symphony that celebrates the wonder of existence. The eldest son, Eric, can hardly contain his excitement. He's always been enamored by the northern lights, seeing them as a gateway to a world far beyond human comprehension. He grabs his sketchbook and colored pencils, ready to capture the amazing phenomenon you will witness tonight. Maybe we'll see colors we've never seen before, he muses, his young imagination already painting the sky in colors of unimaginable beauty. There is something about the existence that these amazing people live in, that is so richly human. They live in a way that is little removed from our very ancient ancestors. For they are not the only inhabitants of this icy world. They live in a community of Inuit people who all look after each other and have fostered a deep sense of community. And say, perhaps, if one were to stumble across this little community, you might notice one very clear characteristic. Everyone is smiling. It's like the essence of this community lies not just in their connection with nature, but also in their genuine connection with each other. Their smiles aren't just expressions. They are windows into a world that values togetherness and collective well-being over material gains. As the night unfurls, people from neighboring igloos begin to gather near the frozen pond that serves as the community's natural gathering point. It's like an unspoken tradition, this communal watching of the northern lights. The elders, bearers of wisdom and history, take their seat on intricately carved wooden stools, while children scamper around, their laughter echoing like a sweet melody across the frozen landscape. As the sky gradually darkens, anticipation fills the air. It's almost palpable, like the buzzing of static electricity before a storm. Even the animals seem to sense the forthcoming spectacle, as the usually vocal Arctic foxes and snow hares grow quieter, as if paying respect to this special event. Handmade drums and flutes are brought out, ready to accompany the dance of the sky with an earthly tune of their own. Mila, the community's revered storyteller, prepares herself to narrate an ancient tale that has been passed down for generations. She tells it only on nights like this, when the northern lights are expected to grace the skies, as she begins her story. Mila's voice rises and falls as the first streaks of color begin to appear in the sky. It's as if the heavens themselves have heard the story and are painting their response in strokes of greens and pinks and purples. It's like a magical collaboration between earth and sky, between human voice and cosmic spectacle. Mila speaks. Long ago, when the earth was still young and the sky was a blank canvas, lived a wise elder named Nuka and a young warrior named Siku. They belonged to a tribe much like ours, living at the cusp of earth and sky. Their lives intimately tied to the elements. However, the tribe faced a perilous threat. Endless winter, a cruel season that showed no sign of breaking, endangering their way of life. Desperate to help their community, Nuka and Siku ventured into the icy wilderness in search of the midnight sun, a mythical orb said to hold the essence of all seasons. Legend had it that whoever managed to find and touch the midnight sun could call forth the dormant spring and bring balance back to their world. armed with ancient talismans and a sled of hardy huskies. They journeyed far from home, guided only by faith and ancestral wisdom. As they ventured farther, the sky grew darker, and it was then that they heard it, the song of the Ice Maiden, guardian of the midnight sun. She was intrigued by their courage and their quest, and the Ice Maiden presented them with a riddle they must solve to prove their worth. With hearts pounding, Nuka and Siku answered her riddle correctly, impressing the guardian enough to grant them access to the midnight sun. Upon touching the mythical orb, Nuka and Siku felt a surge of energy course through them, as if they had tapped into the very heartbeat of the earth. At that moment, the sky erupted into a cascade of colors, a dance of light so magnificent it took their breath away. They had unlocked the first northern lights, an eternal bridge between earth and sky, mortal and divine. The seasons began to shift, slowly but surely, until spring returned to their world. Returning home as heroes, Nuka and Siku shared their experience, and ever since, the tribe gathered every year to celebrate this celestial event, seeing it as a continuous dialogue between humans and the cosmos, a celebration of resilience, unity, and the human spirit. There, Mila ended her tale, her eyes shimmering like the lights above, leaving the community to ponder once more. The interplay between their lives and the universe's endless wonders. These northern lights are also known as the Aurora Borealis. They are a natural light display, seen in high latitude regions like the Arctic, but it's not just the northern half of the Earth that sees lights like this. The southern hemisphere has its own version, called the Aurora Australis, mainly visible in the Antarctic regions. The northern lights have fascinated people for centuries, and there are many myths and stories that surround this amazing phenomenon. They're often seen as spiritual or supernatural phenomena. So, in a way, the northern lights serve as a beautiful intersection of science and human storytelling. As the different colors stretch across the sky, transforming it from an inky black canvas to a swirling masterpiece of light. The little igloo community holds its collective breath, Anna and Eric's faces light up, mirroring the astonishing display above them. Their eyes widen in sheer wonder, as if they are looking at magic, which in a way they are. For children who grow up listening to stories where the boundaries between the earthly and the divine are as thin as a snowflake, this celestial event feels like a validation of all of their innocent beliefs. Anna clings to her mother, her tiny hands gripping the soft fabric of her blanket, as if trying to hold on to this moment forever. She turns to look at her family, her gaze lingering on each face, as if memorizing this perfect instant, where everything and everyone she loves are lit by this otherworldly glow from above. Eric, his sketchbook momentarily forgotten, is completely engrossed. His usually restless hands are still. His artistic ambitions humbled by a sky that no human hand could replicate. He leans into his father, feeling a wordless exchange of emotions, a silent understanding that some experiences are so grand, so profoundly beautiful, that they defy words. The family, cozy now, tightly knit in their warm lairs and surrounded by their loving community, share this extraordinary moment as one. The northern lights continue their cosmic ballet, casting their radiant spell on everyone below. For Anna and Eric, this isn't just another night. It's a lifelong memory that they will carry with them forever. A spectacular show put on by the universe. Making them feel both incredibly small and infinitely significant at the same time. In a way, in this moment, it feels like Earth and space become one. There is no division between the two, and a feeling of deep interconnectedness transcends each one of the human beings gathered together. For the gathered community, the icy plains beneath their feet and the colors above cease to be two separate realms. It feels as though the northern lights are are not just a phenomenon to be observed, but a communication, a cosmic language spoken without words. The elders and the young ones, those who have witnessed the lights year after year, and those for whom this is a first-time experience, or feel it. It's a feeling that can't be easily put into words, but it's as palpable as the frosty air they breathe. A feeling that fills them with humility, yet makes them feel incredibly grand. As if they are both specks of dust and architects of galaxies. Parents sneak glances at their children, catching the look of wonder in their eyes, and know that they are witnessing a formative experience. These young souls are learning not just about the beauty of the world they inhabit, but also about the profound connections that run through all things, seen and unseen. Now, with a rosy glow of contentedness resting within each one of them, the community silently go back to their respective igloos as the final hues of the northern lights dissolve into the night sky. Each member of the community feels a sense of completion, as if they've just closed the final chapter of a captivating book. And in their silent departure, they exchange warm smiles and hugs, looking forward to being inside their cozy igloos, guided by the soft glow of lanterns and the remaining shimmers of the celestial display. Upon entering their igloo, Anna and Eric are swept into a comforting embrace by their parents. The lingering energy from the night's spectacle enveloping them like a warm blanket. The family gathers around their small burning fire, its light, casting a gentle glow on their faces. No words are needed. Their contented smiles speak volumes. One by one, they settle into their sleeping furs, tucked closely together in a circle around the fire. Its embers dance and flicker, mimicking the northern lights, as if bidding them a final sleepy farewell. And it's under this tender communal glow that each member of the family drifts off into a deep, restful slumber. As they sleep, the extraordinary feelings of the evening weave themselves into their dreams, merging with flights of fancy and deepest wishes. Even in this realm of unconsciousness, the sensation of unity, of being a small but meaningful part of a great big universe, stays with them. And so, under a sky returned to its velvety darkness, our little family, and indeed their entire community, find themselves at peace. They sleep not just as individuals, but as parts of a greater whole, a cosmos infinitely complex, yet profoundly simple. A universe that we